So next up, we have an interview. So let me tell you a bit about the next interview. It's about a multinational group of manufacturing companies that is headquartered in Lebanon, with 10,000 employees worldwide, working in 71 companies. On its helm, a person who has contributed a lot to his society and is today with us here to inspire us and to share his experiences. Mr. Namat Frem, President and CEO of Indefco Group, will be interviewed by Omar Christidis, founder and CEO of ArabNet. Please welcome them. They should be coming soon to stage. Okay. Please welcome Mr. Namat Frem and Omar Christidis.
So, welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us this morning. It's my privilege to have with us today the CEO of Indefco, Namat Frem. To give you a sense, how many people here know what Indefco does? Raise your hands. Okay, great. So you probably know Indefco as what? Sanita? What do they do? If you'll get some words from the audience. What does Indefco do? Kitchens. Other people? Plastics. Solar energy, yes. What else? Sanita, right? So consumer goods in terms of tissues, et cetera. Manufacturing. So Indefco is a 10,000 employee conglomerate, multinational across multiple markets around the world, working in both energy, manufacturing, and consumer goods. So it's our privilege to have him here with us today to understand how technology and digital platforms are transforming industry, especially at such a large organization. So thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Omar.
I wanted to start out with e-commerce. You know, when people think about industry, manufacturing, they don't immediately think about an important and key role for e-commerce. Can you tell us about what e-commerce efforts that you've done and where you see e-commerce playing in your business?
I want to thank you, Omar, again. Congratulations for this beautiful exhibition outside and this forum here. Thank you for being with us today. First of all, let me correct, take a small thing about Indefco. Indefco primary job is paper industry and plastic industry and packaging. Paper industry, we do paper from starting from trees and the forests, down to a box where we print it and sell it. In the plastic field, we start with pellets and we turn it into a wide range of products from packaging, printed packaging, into until greenhouses. So now in the consumer business, we do the diapers and the tissue products of Sanita and the likes. And then there is a sector which is the technology-based industry where we do the solars, the waste to energy, all kind of automation applications, system integration. So this is what we do. Hala, e-commerce, I had to start with this to tell you that in e-commerce, 15 years ago, we decided that Indefco will be in the e-commerce ahead of the curve. And we did prepare ourselves. And we were probably one of the few companies in the area that were having platforms for e-commerce. I think that the e-commerce, where we really start, where we start to benefit from it, is in the business-to-business. Yani, we have to think twofold. And I've noticed there is a big hype about the consumer side of e-commerce. But Omar, believe you me, in business to business, this is where the money is, and this is where the rubber meets the road in e-commerce. I tell you that as Indefco, we have finished all of this these platforms and exercise, and now we are focusing on how to even go further, designing with our customers. Like when you have a box, for instance, you are, say, a manufacturer of, I don't know, of watches. And you want the right box for your watch. We have applications, we have developed applications. Not only we get in touch with you and we find you, because this is where an e-commerce is very important, what we call the lead generation. The lead generation is the world on its own. How to find those potential customers. So, to answer you very quickly, we are very much advanced in this. I guess,
Anna, if I can interrupt you, just and be more specific, what platforms do you currently have for e-commerce?
For instance, for e-commerce, we are using, we have at least, if I want to look at the numbers, we have around 15 sector portals already. These are 15 portals.
And you go, and people can go in there and buy
and
directly
buy,
through
and
these
buy things,
sites.
And buy things. We do have around, we have reached around $150 million turnover on those platforms.
$150 million turnover on digital platforms, B2B.
And all fields. And this is something very important. We do, what's beautiful about e-commerce is it's if you are able to connect it straight with your ERP systems and your CRM, this is where your metrics are right. So you can have metrics and filters, like what is the lead to RFQ, to request for quotation, so that you are not losing your time with trying to sell some things in the wrong place. So this is.
And you also mentioned some apps that you have for your customers to purchase directly through those.
Yeah, as I told you, we have 15 sector portals. We have 65 corporate websites. From there, we funnel those to portals when needed. But we can also have funneling to the portals through active marketing, digital marketing campaigns, where we go and try to look at potentials and we activate a digital campaign with e-marketing. So there are two ways of getting customers. You either go and push and call them, or you wait until they come. These are two different ways of working.
Great. So, and how would you say the growth of the online platforms is relative to the offline platforms?
I think that it is faster, but they are interconnected. Yani, for those, at least in our world, business to business, for those that believe that we can have a platform without salespeople, we're not there yet. In business to business, the beauty is that you prepare as much as you can this lead, you qualify it, we qualify the lead, and we bring it to a salesperson to follow it up. This is, we found out that this is where we create the highest value.
Okay. So it is an online-offline synergy, which is what really closes the deal when it comes to B2B sales. So, great, this is looking at kind of e-commerce, and it's impressive for me to see this. What about marketing? How do you use digital platforms in your marketing efforts, whether it's B2B or B2C?
Well, in B2B, as I told you, we start by having sectorial studies, and we come out with potential customers, if you want. And then we go and shoot and get in touch with them. This is a marketing campaign, an active marketing campaign for business to business. And the business to consumer, we're not very active starting from Facebook and all of these things. We prefer to usually integrate it with advertising campaigns. What we do, above the line campaigns, we integrate it with digital campaigns. And this is how we try to optimize on it. As far as marketing, pure marketing, the catalogs itself, the management of catalogs and data is very important.
How many products do you guys have?
How do you find products, first of all?
SKUs.
We would have maybe across Indefco group. We never manage.
Yes.
You know, Indefco is more like a group of companies. Sanita has maybe 600 SKU. But across the board, we would have maybe 10,000 SKU.
So
managing those is something very important and very challenging. And حلو. I like the question because this is where we could harness the power of the digital world, and we did create what we called a cross-media and cross-media catalogs. And this was something fantastic because we said we have assets in those catalogs, those data, and we turned it into a cross-media digital asset management system. And we have a system today that manages those worldwide, where our salespeople, our marketing people, can access in real time, anytime they want, from their handheld system, when they are with customers, when they are with where they need any data, and that they can make sure, and they will be sure that what they are getting is their last revision of the product. Because it's very tedious when you have that much products to be having the right info, the up-to-date info.
Interesting. So keeping your sales team on the ground informed, up to date, the latest information about your products and services. Which brings us to the next question, which is you're using it clearly to optimize and increase efficiency of your sales team.
Yeah.
What would you say more broadly, how are you integrating digital tools to boost efficiency and boost internal communications? I mean, you have how many
companies? I think workflows. I think, as a bit dark, the biggest value creator for me is the workflows, the concept, the philosophy of a paperless organization. Only the Microsoft team are going to be very happy with me. I'm a paper maker also, so I am like on your side and defeating my own, betraying my team now. But running a paperless organization is something, especially when you are running multinational groups and manufacturing processes, and you want to integrate those processes with CRM, with customer service management. And if you're able to integrate those with your digital marketing campaigns, there is a lot of synergy and a lot of value creation. It's a seamless link between what you do as pre-marketing effort, like the lead generation, to an RFQ management, request for quotation management, to a sales confirmation, an order processing, to a management of inventory, to processes, manufacturing processes. If you are able to link those seamlessly, you create a lot of value. And guess what? We don't sell paper anymore, a lot. But the value creation is much more. This is why, and we have today at least, excluding the ERPs, the ERPs within the plants, we have around 128 workflows that are running real time now. Starting from, I asked for like to create like small titles for you. I ended up with four big titles for our 128 workflows that are excluding the ERPs, the manufacturing workflows inside. You have the marketing services requests. You've got the customer complaints world. You have the stock tracking world, and you've got the ISO procedure world. At least those, every one of those, a bunch of workflows.
And so these are all being run online real time through
and
your systems.
With 10,000 people around the globe. Plus, I would add, there is another platforms or mechanism or the dynamics to create value and connect people. It's our intranets. So we have at least I counted them. I don't keep the counts. The update, we have 24 corporate intranets today. So these are internal communities within Indefco Group where people are linked, where it's a pure intranet. So intranets are very important for workflows and for connectivity. So we know exactly who's having a newborn and his family, to create this family spirit, to create this alignment of strategies. If I want to communicate something, I can communicate fast. So I think that this is our number two value creator as far in connectivity.
Okay. So of course now we've talked e-commerce, we've talked marketing, we've talked workflow.
Yeah.
But the heart of your business is manufacturing. So, and of course, we have now seen, we're seeing a renaissance in manufacturing. Our magazine cover story is about the blossoming of Arab hardware innovation.
Mm-hmm.
Computers are getting cheaper. Mm-hmm. Crowdfunding is allowing people to develop cheap, new innovative hardware. Where do you see, where are you integrating these new technologies into your manufacturing? Are you using things like 3D printing within your manufacturing processes?
Mm-hmm. First of all, we cannot look at our processes as one sort of processes because we are so diverse from pure heavy industry like paper making to a very light technology-based industry like automation and system integration in a PLC. In every one of those, we have different approaches for automation. First thing, probably in design, when you are designing a machine, the integration between a design, an AutoCAD drawing, and a G-code on a CNC machine, the integration is extremely fast, and this is what we are doing for ages. ERP integration, when you are in the processes, in a plant, in a big heavy industry plant, where you have customers, and you have you are taking this process and this workflow that we said, part of an ERP inside, how do we integrate this with design, with setup settings on the machine itself? The beauty is when you are able to cascade parameters of an order, especially if you are, your target is repeatability, is quality. So you take this data, these setups, these are setups, becomes part of your order. And when you cascade it to your machines as setting for the machine, part of a job order, this is something that we are doing and it's part of our value creation in heavy industry. I would say in, you mentioned digital printing, in our CNC...
3D printing.
In our CNC manufacturing, we did look at 3D printings, but because we deal with a lot of metals, 3D printing is still not there yet, except for, just to tell you, the breaking news 6 months ago, Rocketdyne, which is a joint venture between Rockwell Automation and Aerojet, did create the first jet engine, small jet engine, 100% 3D printed. Just think of the temperature that it can take. Those titanium.
Small jet engine.
Jet engine, 100% 3D printed. So this is still not available for us as technology, but the technology is there. We looked at CNC replacement by 3D printings. We are not there. The technology is not there yet for steel. For plastics, it is there. We do not need it too much because our plastics are flexible packaging. We are into flexible packaging, so we don't need it. But I want you to know that technology-wise, we do use a lot of, because we are specialized in technology in automation, we have full plant-wide control systems. We call it SCADA systems, if you're familiar with SCADA systems, for those of you that knows. So this is where you control a full plant, where you have, let's say, 5,000 input-output, pressure, temperature, speed, you name it, level. You control it from one control room. This is what we, first of all, do as far as service and our automation capabilities. But as customers, we use those in our plants. We do use also on automation itself on machines when we replay, when we want to go high speed with lines, you replace the shafts, the normal shafts, with real time, we call it vector controlled motors, where they talk to each other in real time, the motors. This is part of automation. Last but not least is quality control automation, where you have vision recognition, real time vision recognition, where you've got cameras and you take pictures, where you make 20 checks on a piece, and then you are making 600 pieces per minute. Just imagine the speed of the processes and processors that are able to detect, yes, no, this is a product that we accept, this is a product we don't accept. This is as fast as the world of technology is in a group as fast as in DEFCO.
Excellent. So e-commerce, marketing, workflow, manufacturing,
yes,
automation, it is really part of every part of your business.
Akid.
Now something for the entrepreneurs. What will it take to create a smart device or smart device innovation hub in Lebanon? Do we have a role that we could have entrepreneurs here creating smart devices, building a new type of manufacturing industry here?
Yes.
You're in the leadership of this syndicate of industrialists.
Thank you. First of all, Omar, yes, the answer is yes. The answer is the world that we are living in is getting more and more Lebanese-like, Lebanese-friendly. Okay. I will tell you what I mean by this. Lebanese have a particular gift of system integration, of integrating everything to everything. When you think of how we live, this melting pot that is Lebanon is really developed an integration capability which is unheard of. And when you start to see the building blocks available in this new world, due to the digital world, but also due to the communication world and the openness of borders, and the outsourcing world that is today, we have building blocks to just imagine an idea, integrate a concept that does not exist from 5 or 6 disciplines, and you guess what? You find the tools today to implement your ideas. You did not have this 20 years ago. I'm not talking 100 years ago. 20 years ago, you did not have these building blocks available the way they are, with starting from Microsoft building blocks that you can use to Festo in the diplomatic world, to in the control systems and Siemens, Parker Hannifin and the hydraulics.
And even being able to plug in funding through exactly, crowdfunding or other sources, right? So it's all kind of plug and play now.
So those building blocks are here. What we need is the right integrator. And I guess our young generation are particularly well-placed and well-trained and brought in, it's even genetic, to build those connectivity and come up with a product that where the result, the sum of the components is the product is much more than the sum of its components.
But what's standing in our way? This will be the last question before
First
we wrap up.
First of all, I wouldn't
or
say
what
that
do we need
standing.
To, what do we need to do to make
more.
To boost it
and
more?
I
yes.
believe that I'm very satisfied with the outcome. When you look at what our youngsters are doing in this world compared to the average median value creation of our ecosystem in Lebanon, they are ahead of everybody. For sure, ahead of the politicians. Ahead of any other sector in Lebanon. Hala, how can we boost it faster? Our laws in Lebanon. If you want to be, first of all, I'm not. If you want to talk about the Lebanese, we need to keep them. Just stay away from them. They know what to do in the world. But if you are talking about Lebanon and
Lebanese in Lebanon, that's
Lebanese right. in Lebanon, which Lebanese is a completely different situation. Lebanese in Lebanon, what we need first is modernization of the laws. Our laws are invalidated by events. We have to modernize them. To modernize them, we need to create the right decision-making processes in the country that allows this to happen. And this is where the catch-22 is. Which comes first? Modernization of the laws that allows our decision-making processes to function, or the decision-making processes to function first so that we have new laws. This is part of a problem that is beyond the discussion of this forum. Two, I think that we need a physical place. We need industrial parks. We need with microcosm of power, of broadband, so infrastructure, if not a countrywide, at least in microcosm. Okay. So this is number two. And number three, keep up the good faith and the faith in Lebanon so that people are able to stay and take risk in Lebanon and not leave if they have a good idea.
Great. I think we are actually out of time. Maybe I will take one more. Do I have time for a question? I have no time for a question. Okay. How many people here do have questions? Let's see, from a show of hands from the audience. Okay, well, If you do have questions, and I guess some of you do, but you're not raising your hand right now, we will be just outside after this session. Come out and speak with us. We'll be happy to answer your questions. Nama, thank you very much for joining us. It's a pleasure to have you and to hear about really a CEO-driven agenda for digital integration in one of the largest manufacturers in this country. So thank you very much.